Okay, guys. Yeah, it's me again. None of my co-authors wanted to come to Ithaca. I don't know why. Anyway, so these are very different settings. I'm studying most of my research is about sharing economy or online reviews. In this case, I'm looking at what happened since now online reviews are very popular. What happened to advertising spending, and I do so in the context of the hotel industry. Okay. Just let me motivate this a little bit. What I'm showing you here is an advertising from the Hotel Marriott in Marina del Rey, Los Angeles. This advertising has a lot of purposes, including creating awareness, signaling quality, the beautiful view of this hotel, right? Prices, this description says something about prices. Persuade users to buy, to book this kind of hotels, okay? And if you think about, 20 plus years ago, probably advertising would have been the only way in which hotels could signal this kind of information to users, right? But things changed a lot in the last decade, and now we have a platform like TripAdvisor, which also provide a lot of information about hotels, including prices, quality through reviews, and more, okay? And this platform became actually very, very popular. These are 2017 statistics for TripAdvisor. 7 million accommodations, 600 million reviews, which they basically double in 2 years from 2015 to 2017. Over 450 million monthly unique users. Okay, so these platforms are really popular, and we use them a lot to make decisions. And that's what you do, what you'll find if you search for the same hotel on TripAdvisor. You will see a signal of quality, which is the 4-star ratings. You can read all the reviews. You can see the prices. Okay? So basically, review platform provide cheap and reliable source of information about quality. They reduce search costs. They provide pricing information. Basically, what these platforms are doing are reducing information asymmetries between hotels or firms and consumers, right? And this must have some impact implication on traditional marketing practices like advertising, branding, and pricing. And indeed, there is a lot of, we see a literature coming up in marketing and economics. Most of these papers are recent. There is some from 2006, but most of them are 2016-17, where researchers started looking at the effect of reviews on brands, on pricing, or on advertising. For example, Michael Luca, in a very popular paper, showed that by just increasing your star rating by half star, you can get 5 to 9% higher revenue as an hotel. Moreover, it shows that this effect is very different from chain and independent. And it demonstrates that the chain are more immune to star rating than independent hotels. So what I do in this paper, I focus on advertising. I empirically investigate the effect of reviews and ratings on how much hotels spend on advertising. And then try to answer these three questions. Do firms adjust their price, their advertising strategy now that reviews are so popular? Are advertising and reviews complement or substitutes? And what is the role of advertising in this new environment? Do we still need advertising? Again, the setting is the hotel industry, very important industry, 200 billion in revenue in 2015. First empirical challenge here is putting together the data. It's very difficult to find advertising data. And if you find it, it's generally very noisy and not very detailed. Reviews easy. Reviews, I just scraped TripAdvisor. I got all the reviews in the US and hotels from about 90,000 accommodations. That's the easy part. Advertising, there are companies that gives you data. One of them is Kantar Media. I don't know if you're familiar with it. They have this data called ad spend data. About a bunch of industry, including the hotel industry. And we got data from them for about 15,000 hotels for different media, including internet, print, outdoor radio and TV. The problem with this kind of data, it is very, there are not too many details. So what I get is the hotel name, the brand, and sometimes the location, not even always. And finally, I got some data from STR, which is a company that tracks hotel performance all over the world. From them, I got basically the US hotel census that contains information such as whether the hotel is independent or a chain, the price category, the class category, etc. So now that I have all these three data, I had to put them together, right? I had to match them. I don't want to spend too much time here. I just want to tell you that it took me a long time to figure out a way to match this data because of Kantar lack of information. But some information about my final data set is a panel of about 600,000 hotel year month observations. So I have monthly ad spending for these hotels and monthly reviews for about 4,500 hotels and 2.6 million reviews for about 14 years, okay? Let me give you some descriptive statistics of this data. I think they are interesting. First of all, I look at 2002, the beginning of my sample, and 2015, which is the end of my sample. Hotels, part of the my sample are increasing by a lot. So a lot of hotels start entering TripAdvisor as time passes. As you can see, the fraction of months with advertising decreases. So it seems that, at least observationally, hotels are spending less, are advertising less months now than before. And the fraction of hotel reviews, reviewed obviously increased a lot. With the popularity of TripAdvisor, many, many more hotels are available on this platform. Okay. Rating and reviews, if you look at the average rating, it increased a little bit from 2002 to 2015. The number of reviews increased exponentially for everything. Now, if you look at the advertising spending by month, you can see that internet increases as we expected. Not that the internet for, in this case, is only display ad. I don't have search, okay? Everything increases and the rest decreases, okay? As we expected. Some visual evidence of this is that on the left, I plot the number of reviews year over year, exponentially increasing. And if you look at advertising, it moves from 2,000 a month in 2002 to about 770 a month in 2015, okay? Again, these are all observational evidence, no causal inference here, nor causal relationship, but you know, it's interesting to see this kind of trends. More trends, if I look at advertising spending by hotel types, for example, by scale and by operation, we're spending more upscale hotel. And if we look at independent versus chain, there is a slightly difference between them, and it seems that the advertising spending for independent is decreasing, for chain is decreasing at a faster rate, even though the difference is not statistically significant. Last piece of descriptive evidence that I want to give you that I think is interesting is the relationship between star rating and advertising in early period and late period. In early period, what we see is that there is basically no relationship. Everything seems random. But if we move to the late period, it seems that there is an inverse relationship. So, and we see that hotels at extremes seems to advertise less, as suggested in these two papers. And most of the action is around 4 stars. And if we look at the distribution of the hotels in our data set, most of the hotels are exactly around these 4 stars average, okay? So this could suggest that when ratings cannot differentiate between different hotel quality, advertising can enter and play a role there as a differentiator. You're gonna test this in the paper, and it's actually true. So Empirical analysis, what I'm trying to do here is measure the causal effect of ratings on advertising spending. This is obviously complicated because there are many unobservables. Hotels decide when to advertise. They cannot control too much ratings, but they can control when they advertise, right? So what we do, we are going to exploit one of TripAdvisor feature, which is the fact that TripAdvisor round rating to the next half star. So if your average is 4.24, the display rating will be 4. If your average is 4.25, the displayed average will be 4.5 stars. So there is this half star difference, even if the real quality is very close. Essentially, my empirical strategy is the regression discontinuity. If you're not familiar, I'm going to give you RD101 in this plot, which is very simple. So 375 is my threshold, where on the right of the threshold, I will see a 4-star average, and on the left, I will see a 3.5 average. Okay? Then I can compute the ad spending on the left, on the right, and discontinuity. In a very narrow bandwidth, and the bandwidth should be narrow because what we want for these points to be, for the hotels on the left and on the right to be basic, to have basically the same quality and to be distributed randomly, okay? Well, we measure at, we could measure advertising rating, advertising spending different ways. We measure it at the end of every month, which is generally a conservative approach, assuming that hotels can actually move up in the threshold before the end of the month, right? This is not, these are design applied quite often in economics. A couple of papers that do kind of the same are Anderson Magruder, Luca, and Lay 2017. So identification assumption here are two. First, we need that the average rating are continuous as a function of underlying quality. That means we need to focus on a very small bandwidth. And then conditional of the underlying quality and the bandwidth chosen, basically being below and above discontinuity should be random. This means, in simple words, that hotel cannot manipulate ratings to move just above the discontinuity. Okay? We're going to test this thing in the paper and show that these two assumptions hold. The specification is a traditional RD specification. I don't want to spend too much time here, but basically we use log ad spending as a dependent variable. Beta 1 is the variable of interest, which is an indicator of whether the rating of hotel I at time t is above the threshold. Then we have the true average ratings. And we allow also for different slopes on the left and on the right of discontinuity by including this interaction. This is a standard coefficient included in a RD design, okay? A note about the dependent variable, we use ad spending in months TT plus 6. This helps us reduce noise in the advertising spending. And this actually, in many cases, a conservative approach because if the hotel in these 6 months move up and down a couple of times, you are basically underestimating the effect of rating changes. We do robustness check with using just T and results are the same, okay? 5 minutes, okay. We estimated this in a classical way, which is a local linear regression, and a bandwidth that is very small, 0.05 stars around the discontinuity. These are the visual results, okay? Below the discontinuity and above, what RD is measuring is basically this jump, okay? In this plot, I put together all the threshold between 3 and 5. Below 3-star rating, there is no many hotels, basically. We do so because when we run the regression, we got more or less the same negative statistical coefficient across different threshold. So our main results are the pooled one where we put together all the threshold, okay? So moving above reduce spending by about 9%. Not trivial. And this also suggests that rating and advertising are substitute, not complement. Okay? So if I'm able to to have higher ratings, I probably spend less on advertising because the two things give me the same information. And if you think about it, ratings are cheap, ratings are free. There are many more results in the paper. I don't have time to go over them, but we do a lot of analysis about heterogeneity of the effect, late period versus early period, types of hotels by operation, et cetera. Robustness checks, these are important in RD. We do a lot of them. Especially we are concerned about the continuity of the running variable. This shows that the density of the ratings doesn't jump around the discontinuity, which is good for us. More tests about rating manipulations. The main problem here is that, you know, as a hotel, if I know that I can move by only 0.01 and increase my average rating by half star, maybe I start writing fake reviews, right? I put a bunch of 5 stars and I go up. This is a problem for RD. So we do a bunch of tests. We don't see effect of this type. We also look at the review responses. So now hotels can respond to reviews. And this, it seems to increase average rating overall. So we check whether hotels respond more when they're below or above discontinuity. We don't see this kind of behavior. This is, again, good for us. And then, as is common in this kind of analysis, we do a lot of sensitivity analysis with different event the dependent variable. We add controls, even though you don't really need to use controls in this kind of analysis because the assumption is that everything is random. We use a quadratic polynomial estimator instead of a linear one, different bandwidths, so we increase or decrease the bandwidth to see if the results are sensitive to the bandwidth. And we do some placebo tests where basically you run the discontinuity regression on a point where there is no discontinuity, right? And all these results, all these robustness checks hold, which suggests that our design is correct. So just a brief conclusion is about what I show you here. I demonstrated to you that there is a causal effect on rating on advertising spending. In particular, highly rated hotels substitute free advertising for paid advertising. And not so highly rated hotels, they still have to advertise. This is one of the implications of the paper. There are many more if you want to read the paper, and more results and related implications. So if you are more interested in knowing more about the paper, please come chat with me. And thank you.
The first one is, where do you think their money is going instead of the advertising? Do you think they're incentivizing people to do the reviews by giving them like free meals or something? Or are they like spending money on the quality of the...
That's a good question. I don't know. Maybe in quality, improvement in quality. I'm not sure. That's an interesting question. And unfortunately, I'm not able to measure these kind of things. But it would be interesting to understand how much they're saving, where this money are going, actually. I see.
Change.
So, right. That's another interesting question because there could be the other effect around. Yeah. So you're basically suggesting also advertising could improve ratings or because of, no, sorry, sorry, more spending, advertising spending can improve ratings.
Yeah, maybe they're spending money on like,
right.
Either getting better ratings.
Right. Right. Yeah. Right. We didn't look at that, but it's a good question. We don't have search.
So how do you know that like the gap isn't, like that the advertisers aren't just spending all of them on search?
Yeah, that's, I don't know.
Do you have any idea?
That's why.
Could you look at perhaps the auction prices to sort of get some sense of how competitive the market is, how much?
So a big limitation of this paper is we don't have search. Unfortunately, it's very hard to get search. I honestly don't think that the trend is gonna flip. Okay, that is the spending is going to increase because search is pretty cheap. But we are in talk with a company and see if we can get some data and take a look because it will be interesting.
Actually, can you clarify, you have display ads?
I have display.
Does that include ads on Facebook? Or
Everywhere that is display. But no social media.
No social media.
No, only display ads, so banners.
Spending as a a dynamic investment decision. And I wonder whether on the right-hand side, you should control not just this month review, but some version of, you know, you might be responding not just in today's
yeah.
review, but in the past cumulative 5 month or 1 year's review.
That's a good point. So that's a good point. And that's why we use a window for the that spending and not for the review. So basically we do the opposite of what you suggested. I use a longer window for that spending because we assume basically that hotel can spend in advance, right?
But I think on the regressor, you might also want to consider,
yeah.
On the
it could be, yes. Yes.
I think you have more to answer.
Do we have more to answer? No. So yeah, we do see a difference. So basically,
okay.
chain seems to be in the, immune,
okay.
so there is no effect, and mostly is independent.
Yes, I think you raised your hand first. Sorry.
Oh.
So do you have any implication on the like advertising firms like Google or Bing?
So unfortunately, again, I don't have search. I can tell you about display ad spending is still increasing. So. Internet ad spend is still increasing. We still see a negative effect of the discontinuity. Implication for Google, I don't know. I didn't think much about it.
But do you know any research around this? Like that you said that the overall
no.
trend of advertising is decreasing.
Yeah, but yeah, yes.
Internet
is going up, okay, obviously. At the discontinuity, there is still a negative effect. So if I have a higher rating, I advertise less because rating says already a lot about me. I don't know what could be the implication for Google, but Google is going to be happy anyway because there's going to be always bad hotels that need advertising, I think. So, yeah. Yeah.
Yes,
that's good. I was just going to ask, I mean, you don't really need comparison of to estimate what the search rate is. I mean, you need to run some kind of robot bot to find out how many responses you get.
Say it again. Sorry.
I mean, there's a way of estimating.
But if
search
I want,
the
yes and no, okay? Because doing so, I get instantaneous spending. If I want something in the past, I need a company that tracks these trends, right?
Yeah.
But yeah.
Okay, we have to go.
Thank you very much for the question.